So life does not get much better for me than when I get to hang with my favorite, I like to call him my metal teddy bear, the one and only Zakk Wylde. It's a Jersey night. I feel the magic. Do you feel it?
These are my folks, the reason why it doesn't get much better. She's been locked in her basement for 8 years. So therefore, anything is better than being locked up in the basement.
So No. I'm so happy to see you. I'm so happy to see you. I know. I set myself up for that. So wait, we got to talk about the new record. Because sometimes we get off track, you know, we go a little wild. But I got to tell you, Catacombs of the Black Vatican, amazing, amazing record. What I love the most about it is, and you've often joked, I make the same record. It's not the same record.
In between the songs.
Will you stop? It's so reflective of what I love Black Label and you for. Shred and melody. That's what I hear on this record. There's so much great guitar playing and so much great melody. And your voice is like the instrument that stands out the most.
And I'll pay you that $40 as soon as we get that.
Thank you, Mr. Zakk. But really... Well, when you were making this, though, I mean, did you feel like this is one of those records that just has taken us to a different level? Or, I mean, I just hear so much soul and heart in this collection.
I think every record you make, we had a great time. I've had a great time at making every record I've ever made. So, I mean, when we did No More Tears, it wasn't like, this is going to, do better than No Rest for the Wicked. Mm-hmm. It's just kind of like, this came out really good. I mean, but then when we got done with No Rest for the Wicked, with Miracle Man and all that stuff, I was like, this came out really cool. Mm-hmm. So, I think if you ask any band or any of your favorite artists or whatever, just like if you ask Zeppelin, if you said, did you know Zeppelin 4 was going to be the one? They were like, yeah, but 1 and 2 and 3 we thought were
yeah, cool. Right, exactly.
I don't think look at it that way. Or AC/DC. Did you know Back in Black was going to be the one? He's like, dude, Highway to Hell was pretty cool, too. When they got done with that one, they were like, dude, it just came out great. I just think with every... I think, if you ask any band or any artist or anything like that, I think they'll go... When they got done with their last record, they're like, man, we're really happy with it or whatever. So, no, I definitely... As far as... because it's music, it's not sports, so it's just not,
it's not a competition.
Or the bench press competition, you can go in if your last bench was 500 at your last competition. If you're going in, obviously, the goal is to do 505. Whether you do 525 or 505, you want to outdo your last best was 500. So, I think in that realm, maybe, you're trying out through the production as far as fidelity-wise, as far as the shimmering highs, the mids, the bottom end, So overall, it sounds bigger and the clarity and fidelity. But as far as writing, I think that just comes down to whether it's, with, hold on, JD, I'm just knocking out this interview right now. So
JD just came in.
Come on in, JD.
This is your home. Come on in. We'll finish. All right.
Okay, go ahead now.
Well, I want to talk too about you being, you're kind of like a generation's guitar hero now. You're there, Robin Trower. You're there, Frank Marino. What do you think about a lot of these upcoming guitar players?
Well, that's because JD said, Zakk, if you just stick around long enough, they'll have no one left to listen to. It's not because they think you're the best. There's just no other options. Anyway.
That's not true. We're at a sold-out show tonight. No. We're at a sold-out show tonight. I mean, the guys that you grew up listening to, Jimmy Page and Hendrix, and you're that guy now for a lot of this generation of rock and roll fans.
It is a sad state of affairs, isn't it?
I tell you, he's a humble dude. Hey, speaking of Hendrix, you were out on the Experience Hendrix Tour.
Yes.
A lot of great guitar players. Amazing, right?
Yeah, it was awesome. I mean, aside of honoring Jimmy's music and all that. I mean, that was amazing in itself. But, definitely being... Because you were in the submarine with all the guys.
Yeah.
So,
some amazing players. Yeah, Kenny Wayne was with you.
And stuff like that. So, but it was funny just hearing, all their years of Harris stories in the music business. So, It's like sitting around like a campfire and everybody just telling these ridiculously Spinal Tap stories. So, I mean, that was worth the price of admission.
Well, I loved knowing that you were going to be on a lot of these dates, too, because I'm thinking, you know, there's a lot of people that will be in to see, like, Buddy Guy and Johnny Lang. And then Zakk is going to come out, and they're just going to be like, what the heck? I mean, that's probably was like a cool thing for you to do, to go out in front of all these folks.
Without a doubt. It was, it was definitely way cool. So, yeah, for sure. Because you're hanging around a bunch of, like you said, I mean, amazing guitar players and amazing musicians, bass player, Tony Franklin.
Oh, phenomenal. Phenomenal.
All the guys. So, I mean, it's just, but generally awesome people, though. You know what I mean? Just super cool people.
So I was watching you guys on Twitter and Facebook, and it looked like such a fun tour. You guys looked like you were really having a great time.
I would do it again, for sure.
Yeah. Before I let you go, too. So the guitar ends up in the freaking pawn shop. How does this happen? What is going on?
Well,
someone stole it from you?
Yeah, they came right in here, just like it was sitting right over there with a bullseye.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah, and just took it. Yeah, but I mean, 25 plus years doing this, and I've never had anything stolen off the bus, being because, you know, you usually lock the bus, and, you know, just roasting Andy after him, and he felt horrendous after it got stolen. But I mean,
I would not want to be the person to tell you that.
You gotta, you know, kids, you know, you can't. You can't. You always got to lock the bus. I mean, first off, you can't take a dump on the bus. That's priority number one. But you girls don't do that anyway, so it doesn't matter. But that's rule number one. Rule number two, always lock the bus when you get off it, because it doesn't matter. I mean, you know, I mean, they could have stolen my private porn collection, and that would have been really hard.
Equally as bad. Equally as bad. So you get it back, but wait, you hear it's like at this pawn shop. And then it comes back to you.
Well, they got they gave it to the pawn shop for $50.
Unreal.
So that goes to show you the price of crack cocaine has obviously gone down, because $50 means a lot in the crack world.
It's just insane, insane. It's showtime. I got to let you go. I got to let you jump on stage. Catacombs of the Black Vatican, just a gem, a metal gem. It's like the vocals are Greg Allman-ish, just so good. I'm so proud of you. You just are... I'm going to say our great American rock and roll guitar treasure. How's that?
And I'll be paying you that $40 as soon as this interview gets started. But thanks.
I love you.